Hello everyone. In this video, I will show you how to connect to MySQL database using IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition. I suppose that MySQL Server is already installed on your computer. For more information how to install MySQL on Windows, you can see the video link that is available in the description. So in the Community Edition of IntelliJ, we don't have the database functionality. That's why we need to install a new plugin to connect to MySQL database. So to install the plugin, we have to go to File, then Settings. Then in this window, we have to select Plugins, then Marketplace. And in this field, we have to type Database. So this is the plugin that we have to download. It is called Database Navigator. It has been downloaded this number of times, so we have just to click on this button to install it. Now the plugin is installed correctly, so we need to restart IntelliJ. So let's click on this button, and also let's click on this restart button. So now we can see that this item has been added. It allows us to connect to the database. So let's click on it, and let's click on Database Browser. So in this browser, we have to create a new connection using this button, and it will be a MySQL connection. Now in this window, we have to provide the connection name, so let's call it MySQL connection. So this is the host name, this is the default port number, and I will connect to a database called MyShop. I will connect using the root user. And of course, I need to provide the password. Now let's test this connection. But we have this error. So to fix this error, we have to create a new property called server time zone. So let's close this message and let's go to properties. And here let's create the new property. So for the value of this property, it will be UTC. Let's hit enter and let's go back to database. Here let's test the connection again, and this time the connection is successful. So let's close this box and let's click on OK. Now this connection has been created. We can expand the schemas to see the available databases, and I want to connect to my shop. So let's expand it to see the available tables, and to see the tables I have to expand this node tables. So we can see that I have 5 tables. Now to see the data of a given table, for example, to see the data of this table, I have just to make double click on it. And in this window, I don't need to use any filter. So let's click on no filter. And here we can see the available data of the table. So to add a new row, we can use this button. And here we have to provide the data of the new row. So the ID is auto-incremental, that's why we don't need to provide a value for the ID. So let's add a new client. Now let's hit enter. And for the order date, I don't need to provide a value because it has a default value. Now to validate this insertion, we have to click on this button, commit. And now this line has been added. As you can see, an ID has been added and also a date has been added as well. Now let's create a new row. And let's hit enter. Now let's click on this button to validate the insertion. And as we can see, this row has been added. But here I made a mistake. So to make the correction, I have just to make double click. And now I can modify the value. Now let's hit enter. And to validate this modification, we have just to click on this button. Now the modification has been applied. So to remove a row, I have just to click on it and to click on this delete button. And as you can see, this image has been added, which means that this row will be removed. So to remove completely this row, I have to click on this button, and this time the row has been deleted. Now let's close this page and let's open the SQL console. So to open the console, we can use this button and we have to click on the connection name. Now in this area we have to provide the SQL query that we want to execute. So of course this table belongs to this database, so if you want to see the data of another table from another database, you have just to modify the database here. Now to run this query we have just to click on this button or also on this button. So let's click on this one, and here we can see the data of the table. So to close this we have just to click on this button, and also to close this console we can click on this close button. Now to delete a table we have just to select the table that we want to delete, for example this one. So let's make a right click, then drop. And here we have to click on yes to drop it. And to create a new table, this is not possible for the moment. And as you can see, if I make right click on tables, then new table, I will obtain this error message which says it is not possible to create a new table for the moment. Now to hide this browser, we have just to click on this button, and to show the previous project, we have to click on this button. Finally, thank you very much for watching, and please subscribe to the channel.